back, travelers, to another episode of Random Planet with Life. We're going to go ahead and leave behind our previous planet here and find a nice little area to scan once again. Alright, so for this one, we're going to go ahead and leave the Large Magellanic Cloud, and I want to go visit Andromeda. For some reason, I always seem to find my most favorite planets here in the Andromeda Galaxy. I'm not sure if there's different parameters for the planet generation, depending on the galaxy, but it almost seems like it. Gonna travel around here. It's an interesting nebula there. A very large supergiant. And I'm almost thinking somewhere around here. It's a very bright blue star there. Let's see if we can find something near this blue star. I'm gonna go ahead and pull up our little search. And we're looking for Terras this time. So here we go, give it a scan. And we got a nice healthy list this time, so I'm gonna go ahead and take a moment to go through this list and find our perfect planet. All right, I checked the list, went through, some pretty nice planets in there that I found. One I think we're gonna go with. There's that nebula we saw earlier. Look at this. Another very green looking atmosphere. But look at these interesting lakes, or even oceans, if you could call them that. The coloration on this planet is pretty nice. The kind of blue-green hue to it. But I see quite a number of volcanoes, but also a nice variety of rock formations and mountain ranges, it looks like. So let's go ahead and take a closer look and see what we can find. First, wanted to take a closer look at this, the largest water formation on the planet. It starts off with this weird little tendril here as it expands. You have a nice dormant volcano island there. As we're flying over the largest lake or ocean of this planet. Surface features here. Here's that dormant volcano island we flew over earlier. As you can see from the surface, the atmosphere looks about the same as it does from space. You have that nice green, bluish tint to it. You can see over there in the distance, we have some interesting ravine-like features in the water. In the distance, that's that giant dormant volcano that we flew over earlier. There's some interesting little water features in the ravines here near the ocean. The size of this dormant volcano, or the height, is about 33,000 feet, It's about 20% taller than Mount Everest is. We're gonna take a closer look at these kind of grasslands over here. You can see some large plains of greenery interspersed with these mountains here. So let's see how it looks from the surface. These types of mountain features look very earth-like to me. I like how they're kind of topped with some greenery here and there, kind of sprinkled around. This planet is very mountainous, probably the most mountainous one we've had thus far. The atmosphere of this planet is unfortunately not breathable. It's dominated by nitrogen, and it's about 26% of oxygen. You'd probably lose consciousness without any breathing apparatus in about 3 minutes. Other than that, if you had a respirator, you'd probably be pretty comfortable here, depending on where you go on this planet. This planet is also tidally locked. I've actually only found tidally locked planets with life so far. Hopefully on our next one, we'll find one that's a bit more similar to Earth with a nice day and night cycle. The star of this system is a red dwarf, which is why it has that strange reddish color. Since this planet is tidally locked, it looks like the cloud systems are mainly composed of very high-speed winds here. As for life on this planet, we have marine and terrestrial, which makes sense given the large amount of bodies of water here, and even a nice little river down there you see. Splits off into two other rivers before it goes into the ocean. Most of the volcanoes on this planet are about 40,000 feet tall. They are very active. Counted about 20 to 25 giant volcanoes scattered around here. This is one of the largest volcanoes I've found, with a total height of 52,000 feet. As you can see, there's miles of magma pouring down the side here. Through some of these bulbous mountain range areas that we've seen. This river goes on for quite some time until it empties into the ocean. These mountains aren't quite as high as the other ones we've seen, only reaching about 20,000 feet. Number of them. It's quite impressive. around several large deserts here that span for thousands of miles. Temperature in these regions must be pretty intense, hovering around 130 to 140 Fahrenheit due to that thick atmosphere and the greenhouse effects. There's that giant volcano we visited earlier. You can see just how large it is here from space. As we pass over this side of the planet, you see all the complex ravine systems and different types of mountain ranges scattered about. Desert there, spanning for about 8,000 miles in each direction. Found this interesting body of water here. It's almost like a river. It's been over flooded. We have a nice lush looking area down here. Closer look at these deep ravines over here. Quite the impressive ravine and river system over here. You can see the greenery lining the shores. Seen that yet on any of these planets. We're gonna go ahead and say goodbye to this planet, and until next time, we'll see you again.